Okay, today in the kitchen we have the Space Explorer by Yonezawa. I guess around 1968, and they made them into the early 70s as well. The earlier versions had a switch button on the top of the head, plus the switch on the back, and the one on the top would start the actions, and it basically would run through a cycle and then stop, and then I guess that was problematic, so they just went to the one switch that you turn on. But this would be one of the earliest transforming robots. They weren't called transformers yet, but it's to change from a large console looking TV screen into a robot with a 3D screen and kind of a wobbling walking action, arms come out, head comes up, with really cool sequential flashing lights in the eyes, very different. Okay, I'm going to turn off this overhead light over the stove where we're filming this so that we can see the eye lights better. And I'm looking for the switch in the dark. There we go. And here he comes. There he is, fully extended, and that's the kind of waddling that he makes. Look at those cool eye lights. And the screen has got a 3D depth to it. I'm going to shut it off in the up mode here so we can turn the lights on and look at it a little bit better. You're not going to get 3D on a camera, but to the human eye, it's got a lot of different layers to it, a lot of depth. You can see the walking action is done by concentric rubber wheels that have nubs that stick out, and that's what makes it waddle as it walks. And let's switch it back on again. And there we have it. It's going to repeat its actions. They're extremely sophisticated mechanical toys. They tend to wear out if you find one, it probably won't be working. The lifting action, as you could probably guess, is under a great deal of strain. So you've got pot metal gears, you've got metal stamped gears, you've got a linear ramp gears. I mean, you've got a set of gears that lifts the body, another set of gears that raises the head, and then the arms are on spring loaded, so if a kid grabbed the arms when they're out, it wouldn't break anything. Plus you get the movement of the door. It's there's a lot going on in there, and then of course the eye sequencing flashing system going on. So very sophisticated toy, tends to wear out easy if it's played with too much. Came in this brown color and the red color, like I said, and the earlier versions have the button on top of the head to start the functions, and runs on 2D cells. And I think that's about all I had to say about this great little transforming robot.